Hello everyone, Averick here. Today we'll learn the basics of modding in War Thunder and how to create a custom aircraft using existing War Thunder models. I would highly recommend that you have the War Thunder CDK installed before we begin. We'll use it to find the unit's name and also confirm that our modded units are working. I have also added subtitles to this video that you can toggle on. English is not my first language and I want to ensure you can understand what I'm saying. Let's begin by talking about the folder hierarchy in file placement. Besides the user missions and user skins folders, we also have another lesser known folder, where the primary files of War Thunder are placed. This folder is called the content folder. The content folder may look different for every person, but what is always common among them are the PKG underscore local and PKG underscore user folders. PKG user is used to store user-made models and some other files, which you can also see in the asset viewer. PKG local, however, is the one that the game is better integrated with, and the one that serves the easiest method of pathing files for both unit configuration and user missions. It is also the folder that will allow us to see custom units in the mission editor. In PKG local, we have three more folders: res, levels, and game data. RES is used to store resource files such as models and their textures. Levels is used for locations created using the location editor. Game data is where the primary block files for units and such should be located. In the event that you see none of the folders I've mentioned or will mention later on, please create them as necessary. Also, in case the mission editor fails to detect your files, try to add .folder.blk files for each of these folders with the following content. Inside game data, we have the following folders: flight models, which is used to store aircraft and helicopters BLK files; object groups, which is used to store object group type units such as airfields; sensors, which is used to store radar BLK files for all units; units, which contains another folder hierarchy for all ground-based units, including ships and structures; weapons, which contains a folder hierarchy as well, dividing the many weapons in the game among the unit types. We'll start with the flight models folder. We will create an aircraft with a custom skin applied to it. Begin by creating a blank text file, give it a name with no space or unique characters, and then change its file type to block. This is done by renaming the file. Change the .txt to .blk. Once that's done, you can open the file in any Notepad type of software. I usually alter between Notepad and Notepad++, depending on the complexity of what I'm doing. Since we have virtually no way to know the full config file of the unit we want to mod, we will resort to using a command called include, which will copy the entirety of the .blk file of the unit of our choice. In this case, we will create a custom skin for the F5E. I'll go ahead and download this beautiful skin from War Thunder Live while we're talking. To find the F5E.blk name, we can open the mission editor and find it under the Armada unit type. Or we can go to the War Thunder Wiki, where a list of all unit names is located. Now that we know the exact name of the F5E, our full command should look like this. The next thing to do is to add skin data to the unit, which thankfully we can easily obtain by creating a template for the F5E, or by copying it from the user skin we have just downloaded. We can find our template in the user skins folder. Once we have done that, we will copy the entirety of the code and paste it into the .blk. Now we will add another code block to wrap the whole thing. Add skin curly bracket and then add a closing curly bracket at the bottom. In order to utilize this skin in a mission, we need to give it a name. Let's go with not underscore wardogo. The last thing to do is to pad the skin files correctly so that it may be applied in the mission. You see this line? Simply change it to this. A little known fact is that when creating templates, not all textures that are used by the unit are included in the template. You can try to find those files using the asset viewer, and if you succeed, you can then add a new cutoff block for them within the skin block. Write their name in the from line with an asterisk at the end, and then in the to line you pad them like we did before. And with that, we have our custom F5E ready. Let's just rename the file to something that will be a little easier to find in the mission editor. Let's go with cu underscore f underscore 5e. CU stands for Custom. It's also worth mentioning that inside Flood Models, we have two more folders, FM and Weapon Presets. FM stores the block files that contain the aircraft or helicopter's flight model. Weapon Presets contain the loadout files used by the aircraft or helicopter. There can be more than one preset file for an aircraft or helicopter. We will not be needing to mess with either of these two folders for this tutorial. We've already obtained their data from the original F5's eBLK file. Now let's open the mission editor and create a simple mission with our new unit. First, let's place an armada for the player and assign it as the player unit in the mission. It can be any unit that you own. We cannot pick our custom aircraft, unfortunately. Modded aircraft that rely on existing models cannot be operated by the player. Then, we place another armada, since our custom unit is an aircraft, and then we look for it in the unit list. In the mission editor, it will appear to not be using the skin we gave it, but do not worry about it, it's only a visual thing. Click on the F5E and then scroll down to the skin box, and input the name of the skin we've chosen. And finally, save the mission. Now let's try to load the mission and see if our efforts were successful. Well, it suddenly looks like it worked. The unit is using the skin we have defined for it. I don't know about you, however, that F5E looks kinda sus. How about we try something a little more crazy and change the pilot model in the cockpit? For this, we'll use a command called override. It changes the data within the BLK file we have included, allowing us to alter the unit in virtually any manner. To do that, however, we need to know the content of the BLK file. But fret not, for this one I already know what to change thanks to the sample I-185 that came with the CDK. Now let's see if this actually worked. If you noticed, I did not quit the mission or close the game while making these changes, I simply restarted the mission. The reason for this is that the unit data is cached and is reloaded when you restart the mission, which saves me a lot of time. It also looks like our pilot change was successful, excellent. This concludes the introductory tutorial to modding in War Thunder. We've learned how to create a custom aircraft unit using existing models with the include command, how to change its skin, and also how to change the pilot model using the override command. We have also learned the basic folder hierarchy of War Thunder, which will aid us in future tutorials. Remember to read the description to see samples of what we have learned today. If you wish to better experiment with what you have learned, feel free to download my mods on War Thunder Live. The BLK files there are more complete and can hopefully help you to utilize the include and override commands better by knowing what lines to look for. If you found this tutorial helpful, then please remember to like this video and click the notification bell to stay up to date on new tutorial videos. And don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, thanks friends, see you again.